Welcome, my beautiful Aquarians. I'm Brenda Tarot, and I'm here again today to bring you your tarot, your general tarot and oracle card forecast for the week of April the 12th to the 18th, 2021. Again, this is a general reading. Not every single card or the energy they carry may resonate with every single one of you, but take what you can from it and throw the rest out into the universe. If you want clarity, accuracy, and answers to any personal questions, then I welcome you to go to my website. All that information is listed below at the bottom of this video, my website, my email, my services, and my prices. I truly want to thank you for your interest in my channel, for viewing, for liking, for sharing, and especially for subscribing. Please be sure to click the bell button and make it ring. And also, please be sure to to give me a thumbs up, and when you do subscribe, it certainly helps us out, all of us YouTube creators, and you get notified when any of our readings are out here or any of our videos are out here for you to view. Okay, my beautiful, beautiful Aquarians, here is your forecast for this week. Your all over energy you've been given is renewal. Now, renewal is a judgment card in traditional tarot, and it's reviewing the past with compassion and forgiveness. Time to head in a new direction, clarity on your life purpose in your heart, and you know what to do. So, excuse me, it is a judgment card in traditional tarot, and it's about you making a judgment call, moving forward. It's, you know, it's dropping old values and embracing new ones. It's about liberation, and it's about transformation. This is new beginnings. It's almost like getting given a second chance to go forward and do what you want. It's absolutely a beautiful card when the renewal card comes up. So for some of you, you know, you may have taken an assessment, a favorable assessment of what was going on in your past, and you've tweaked it, you've changed it. You're wanting to go forward in a new direction, and you're about to do that. You're about to make that happen. So this is a great way to start your week, changing things up for the better. Now, your first energy card you've got is potential. Think big for your future. So this is beautiful. This is all about you steadily progressing forward. Okay, this is about you remaining open-minded, and there's more possibilities and opportunities that you can see at this point. So remain that way. Stay focused, but also be open. Be open to new things coming in, because I think you're moving forward and you're doing that anyway. And think big. Go for the big picture. Go big or go home, as they say. Okay, so I think that your goal today and your mantra is, my visions and goals take me beyond my current limitations. Moving forward, realizing that you can do this. You can make what you want happen this week. Stand in your power of creativity, and stand in your power of confidence. Now, your next energy card is coming to life. Yeah, that's exactly what's happening this week for you. Something beautiful is being born within you. It's like a new birth, a new life. It's like you're shedding your skin, and you're going through transformation and metamorphosis to go towards a new beginning. Okay, so maybe a long-held dream is just beginning to show you signs of life. So open your eyes and see. All you have to do is just show up. Okay, this is what it's all about. And when the time is right, all of this is going to surface for the greater good. Between worlds, this has been coming up before for other signs, but it's saying that maybe you need to get things done. It's time to get things done. Okay, and again, this is the card of transitions, you know, not being quite out of one situation and fully into another. So you're going through some sort of metamorphosis here. You're going through some transformation here. So, and you might feel like you're between worlds, where, you know, you have to let go of making assumptions that things aren't going to work out. Keep moving forward, because they will. Okay, this is about you feeling between two worlds, and you know, you're not quite into the other. So this is about completing. Okay, completion of projects, completion of situations. Get something done, make sure it's finished, and then you can move forward in a very progressive manner. Okay, this is about, you know, a combination of timing and luck, and you're going to stumble on something that's going to keep you moving forward in a positive direction. Fabulous. I'm liking how this is starting off already. Okay, let's see what we have here for our tarot reading. Your crowning energy, don't get, you know, up in your head about this, is it is the Three of Swords, and it's usually a card of disappointments. Okay, you're going through this transformation of change here, and maybe it has to do with leaving a situation here, okay, going into a new one, letting go of something. It could have been a misunderstanding that you've had with somebody, or you might feel as though you're lonely right now. It could be relationship concerns for other, but it's also painful revelations that you are going to heal through and take time to heal through them. Okay, so some of you could be going through that right now this week, but the beautiful thing is you are going to heal through it. You're going to be able to, there's going to be changes here for whatever reasons. This disappointment came into play that left you. I mean, some people read it as a third party was a determining factor, that stirred the cauldron and caused a breakup or could be heartbreak, it could be betrayal, whatever. I mean, it stands for a lot of things, but mainly it stands for disappointment here. And you may be going through a grieving period, trying to heal through that. Now, I wouldn't get too up in your head. For those of you that have been concerned about finances, you end up with the Page of Pentacles. And the Page of Pentacles is that messenger that brings you good news about prosperity, good news about finance, all those good things coming into you if you've been concerned about finances. So it's a beautiful card that says don't get up in your head here. Enjoy this, okay? Know that there may be an agreement here or a contract that needs to be signed. Okay, this is beautiful. The Page of Pentacles brings you good news about something coming in. And I love this card because it's about the return of going back to school and maybe taking a new course that's going to help you and add to your resume. And you're doing research at this time. Okay, it's about the material part of your life and the improvement coming in and the good news about financial matters coming to you soon. And know that your plans are moving successfully forward, albeit at a steady pace, not in a big, fast pace, okay? And I think you might be adopting some sort of a new interest in something that's going to benefit you there, feeling that beautiful progress and that beautiful passion for abundance. You've got the Nine of Pentacles here. Of course, the Nine of Pentacles is walking in your garden of abundance, keeping your eyes open, keeping your options open for the new possibilities rolling in towards you. I think that you're almost there. Nine of Pentacles says you're so close. You can taste it. You can feel it. You can almost see it. Beautiful. And then we come in here with the Champion card. And this, of course, is the Chariot. And, the Chariot also stands for travel. Maybe you're going on a trip, whether it's business or it's pleasure. But it's also the card that says you fought a hard fight and you need to commend yourself. You went into the arena with the mindset you knew there was risks, you knew there was going to be consequences, but you went in there with the mindset of winning. And now you have won. So I think you're going to see progress coming into you, whether it's in business or whether it's in your at your place of employment. Maybe you're getting a raise, maybe you're getting a promotion. But I do see that your financial and material part of your life is going to be improving. Why wouldn't it? You have the Star in the center position here above your, and this is you showcasing yourself, showing the world what you have to offer them. You're going to be illuminating your own path here, stepping forward to do that. And you're going to get recognition for what it is that you're doing. It's beautiful. And have faith because you've got this sense of purpose, and it's a prosperous new beginning. And know that you're on the right path now. You mean, you're the showcase here. You're being able to light your own path here and demonstrate what you have to offer to society, what your gifts and your talents and your uniqueness is. This is beautiful. Now, coming below your Three of Swords, you've got the Seven of Swords. Now, the Seven of Swords is the card of deception, deceit, someone sneaking around, spying on you, somebody who wants to ride on your success, the coattails of your success, but they could be stealing something as well. So if there's anything within your personal space that you don't want privy to prying eyes and hands, lock it up, okay? Keep what's precious to you close to your heart. But they're going to get caught because look at the light shining down on them. Somebody's going to tip you off. I think someone's going to say, hey, keep your eyes open. This person isn't as honest and their motives are not as honest as they should be. But they're going to get caught. So I wouldn't worry too much about that. But this could be what caused this disappointment and heartbreak here. Now, the Five of Pentacles coming in towards you is a card. And fives, I always tell you, Fives are the number that refers to challenges, but also the resolution, how you can fix it. So I think for some of you, you may have felt as though you were thrown out in the cold, you were isolated, you were orphaned, you felt alone, or you could have had this feeling of lack and loss. And that can refer to finances. But this says you have the resources out there. You hold the key. Look at the key here. All you've got to do is go through that door of possibilities and options that are out there for you to tap in to get the resources that you need to get you through this. Truthfully, I think you're going to do that. I don't think you're going to have to worry too much. You've got the Page of Swords. A Page of Swords, again, is a messenger. The Page of Swords comes in with something to do with a truthfulness, okay? Comes in here and lets you know that, you're going to be receiving some information that could be a little bit challenging and could create some delays. But the thing is, it's either to do with a contract, a legal contract, or something that you have documentation you might have to sign for the courts. Maybe some of you are dealing with that, whether it's business or whether it's matrimonial. I do think that you're going to find some truthfulness coming in, this information. And you're going to hear it from somebody that it's going to be blunt and they don't have any tact and they're not thoughtful. But don't take it personally. Don't attack the messenger. Just get the message coming in. Now, you're planting your seeds for something here. This is the Seven of Pentacles. Maybe you're working on that resume. You've taken that assessment. You're moving forward. You're trying to complete something here. Okay? And you realize now that you want to see progress coming in. You want to see financial stability here. So you might have put out a resume, a proposal, an idea, and you're waiting to hear how they're going to respond. Maybe you had to sign a document here that you put an offer in that you're waiting to hear about. Know that you did it right. It's just taking time. Don't worry about it. You did everything right. You planted your seeds absolutely the best way you could. Bless you. My husband just sneezed, as you probably heard through the door. We can't always predict what's going to happen in the background noise. Okay, let's start off with our clarification with our Three of Swords. You got the Devil. So somebody here was deceptive. Somebody here might have had addictive behavior, negative, toxic behavior, or they may have had addictions. I think you've made the responsible move to pull away from this situation. You're moving on. I think you're going to give up what no longer serves you, that's not going to help you grow and expand and go in a prosperous, successful direction. The Devil is all about making the right, healthy decisions for yourself. And I think that something surfaced here and you realize that you had to let go of it and you're moving on for your greater good. Let's see what we have with our beautiful money card here. We have our Two of Pentacles here and a prosperous card. You have the excuse me, the Eight of Wands. Now, the Eight of Wands is about really fast and a lot of information, a lot of activity, a lot of events, something coming in towards you. This is the end of delay. So I think you're going to find you're going to be getting very busy and being involved in something. Walking in your garden of prosperity here, you have the Four of Swords. You fought hard. For some reason, you've been very, very busy. And they're telling me that a lot of you were totally stressed out over this situation. And now it's time to take time for you, respite time. Maybe you need to plan a vacation or time away just to go away and enjoy yourself and the space that you need to put yourself in to protect yourself, to heal through a situation. But you're coming out the champion at the other end, and here is your King of Rods. Stay focused on that purpose, okay? Stay focused on the positive part of your week, letting go and but going through a healing process for others. This is a very focused king. He stands his ground. He goes for his goals. And you did that here, and I think that's why you made a decision for the greater good for you. Yeah, you matter. You're the star. Yes, you've got the Ace of Pentacles. Wow, beautiful card. You had the Page, and now you have the Ace. Ace is all about prosperity here with the Ace of Pentacles. On top of the Star card, you can't go wrong. This is beautiful. So you know what? You're going to see opportunities coming in here. You're definitely going to see something come into fruition here. Significant abundance coming towards you. Okay? You may get a promotion, salary increase, or unexpected money coming your way. So again, the material part of your life is working out for the greater good. So you might want to invest in something, but also this also refers to the improvement of health, whether it's spiritual, mental, or physical. Some of you could be going back to school again. I see a degree, a diploma, an award coming in. It's always about excellent luck, shifting of energy for the better. Let's see what we have for our Deception card, Seven of Swords. We have, again, the Three of Swords. I do think that some of you have found that somebody wasn't being honest. Somebody might have been cheating, Somebody might have been trying to take something from you, and their motives were not, they didn't have a lot of integrity. I think somebody tipped you off and they got caught, and you are healing through this disappointment. But trust me, you made the right decision to get rid of that toxic energy or relationship around you. Five of Pentacles, you don't have to worry anymore. I think you're going to find the kindness and consolation and advice from a very wonderful female, and it could be an older woman that's stepping forward, or a mature woman, someone who's lived life. The Queen of Cups has the ability to put herself in her shoes, the shoes of her court. In other words, she's understanding, she's compassionate, she gets how you feel. She could be a healing element. Maybe she's your mother, your partner, your best friend, your aunt. Somebody is stepping forward, and they're going to guide and help you through a situation this week. It could be a water sign. It could be, a Cancer, a Capricorn, or a Pisces. Page of Swords, that card that says you're going to hear some truthfulness, and it's already surfaced. I think you have the Page of Pentacles. Again, double whammy. You're not going to be having to worry too much about the material part of your life. This is good news. Comes in with good news about finances. Some of you could be winning a court situation. Okay, the Seven of Pentacles. You've got the Queen of Pentacles. Being able now to step forward and give birth to your dreams. Yes, whatever you did here, you did right, and you're going to hear good news. Also, she's a very motherly figure. There could be a child being conceived and born into the family circle, an adoption of some sort. But she's like Mother Earth. She has the ability to plant her seeds and watch fruition and abundance grow and her harvest come in. And it lands on that card, which is what you're doing. Wow. Well, my beautiful Aquarians. Quite a prosperous, interesting week here for you, but you are healing through disappointments of the past. Somebody got caught doing something that wasn't honest and truthful, and you've decided that you're out of there. And you're going in a brand new, beautiful, wonderful, abundant new direction. You still feel torn, I think, between the two worlds, but you're going to be able to move through. I think, there's a keep your eyes open to the potential here, and you're going through transformation and a healing and a beautiful new renewal of life. Beautiful. Well, this is your reading for this week, and I wish you a great remainder to today and a beautiful, optimistic week here to look forward to. Always remember, the universe is not happening to you. The universe is reacting to you. So remember that the universe and the divine, your higher power, want you to succeed and find your happiness and peace. So surrender to it and move forward towards your goals and happiness. Blessings, my beautiful souls, and know that I always and only stand in this circle of love and light for you. Let's all play safe, stay safe, and be safe, and we'll all see each other very soon.